Welcome back, everyone. And if this is your first video with me, thanks for taking time to check out my latest video. So before I start today's video, I'd like to just take a quick second and talk about properly parking your motorcycle. I've seen two mistakes being made constantly. First is pulling into a spot headlight first and then pulling all the way forward. The second is backing into a spot, which you should do, but backing all the way in, which you should not do. The proper way to park your motorcycle and safest way to park your motorcycle is to back into a parking spot, leave your front tire in line with the front or rear bumper of the car you're parking next to. So passing traffic is not going to mistakenly think that the spot you're occupying is empty. Thanks for listening, and here we go. Today I'm visiting Greystone Mansion and the surrounding grounds, which are rich in California history. Edward Laurence Doheny was the original proprietor of what would later become known as Greystone Mansion. Construction on the main house began in February of 1927 and was completed in September of 1928. But the entire estate took approximately 3 more years to complete at an unbelievable cost of $3 million, which at the time was an unimaginable sum in real estate terms. Just for context, that $3 million in 1928 is about $50 million in today's money. The original cost to construct the entire Greystone estate was $3,166,578.12. The mansion alone cost $1,238,378.76. The extraordinary final result became known as Greystone for its abundant use of stone in the construction, and that stone's rather somber gray appearance. In addition to the mansion, originally located on the grounds, were stables, kennels, tennis courts, a fire station, a gatehouse, swimming pool, a pavilion, a greenhouse, which, if you stay till the end of the video, you will actually see in this video, a lake, many babbling brooks, some with cascading waterfalls. The 18.3-acre Greystone Mansion was designed by the renowned Southern California architect Gordon Kaufman and was constructed by the P.J. Walker Company using many custom materials, mainly including rare woods, which were ornately hand-carved and used throughout its over 46,000 square feet of living space, and with over 50-plus rooms and 7 chimneys. And this is not including the movie theater, bowling alley, billiard room, or hidden bars. The landscape architect was Paul G. Thine, who used a potpourri of Gothic and neoclassic architectural styles that you can see throughout the property. Now, if you've watched any other videos on Greystone, you'll notice something unusual in mine about right here. While visiting the Greystone Mansion grounds is free and open to the general public, the house is not available to be toured, and it is very rare that you'll even be able to see inside the house itself. So many years ago, I was invited and given permission to visit the property and was let into the house to photograph pretty much whatever I wanted. And while I did not have free rein of the house, I was in there for quite a while and photographed the majority of the rooms. And I can tell you, although I'm showing you, the house is remarkable. Not only is it a remarkable feat of architecture, but it's just awe-inspiring, the designs and the materials that were used. Some of the things that you're seeing here are a prime example of that, including the private bowling alley. On September 16, 1971, the site, including its centerpiece, Greystone Mansion, was formally dedicated as a public park by the City of Beverly Hills. 5 years later, on April 23, 1976, the Greystone Estate was officially recognized as a historic landmark and entered into the National Registry of Historic Places. Then, on January 25, 2013, the Doheny Greystone Mansion was designated a historic landmark, given status number 4 by the City of Beverly Hills, and entered into the Local Registry of Historic Properties. And I think if you're watching the video, you understand why. And because of its location, on a clear sunny day like today, you can easily see from the ocean to downtown. So, believe it or not, this is the Greystone driveway. And here you can see the main gate, which borders the street. And here you can see what appears to be a never-ending road, which is kind of a never-ending road. While I will be walking up the main drive, right now I am on the servant's drive, which leads to the servant's garage, barn, and gas depot. So now we're at the main gate facing the street, and I'm going to be walking up the main driveway to the actual mansion. And I can tell you, you can't really get a sense in the video, but I'm not sure what the grade is here, but I was huffing and puffing pretty good at the top. Thank you. The City of Beverly Hills purchased the property from Mr. Crown in 1965 for approximately $1.3 million, and with plans to install a 19 million gallon water tank on the property, as Greystone's hilltop site would provide tremendous natural water pressure, which I and my heart can both attest to after climbing up that insane driveway. The site continues to serve as the City of Beverly Hills' largest reservoir. So we're now approaching the end of the video, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was a long day, and I appreciate your patience with this 20-minute video, not to mention your patience with my terrible narration skills. I promise I will start working on that and do better. I think I'm also going to try narrating while I'm at the location or while I'm riding, whatever the situation is, just so you get some background ambience noise for where I actually am. Anyways, if you haven't been here, I would highly suggest taking advantage of the unbelievably low price of admission, of absolutely free. And as you saw at the beginning, there is plenty of parking, also free. You can drive right up and enjoy a day walking around what you are looking at right now for yourself. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe, comment, you know, all the YouTube stuff. It actually does make a difference and help my channel and help me, and would be appreciated. So thank you. And till next time.